protein, a concentrated protein. Now, a concentrated carbohydrate is considered to be anything over 20% carbohydrates, and a concentrated protein is anything over 15% protein. So protein comes into the body in the form of, well, if you're eating animals, for example, you'll be eating chicken or fish or meat, for example. What you're taking in is concentrated protein. Protein is made up out of amino acids. Much like carbohydrates are made out of glucose, proteins are made out of amino acids. The difference with proteins is that those amino acids are not all the same. They're actually different shapes and sizes. Your proteins come in the form of amino acids. There are over 20 of these amino acids. 9 of them are considered essential in babies, and 8 of them are essential in adults. Or once you've passed the toddler stage, we need 8 essential amino acids. Out of those 8 essential amino acids, we make over 24 different kinds of protein. Amino acids are the building blocks of protein. The process of protein digestion takes place mechanically in your mouth. You've got to chew the protein. It could be nuts or seeds, for example. Nuts and seeds can contain up to 25% protein, 30% protein, some of them as much as steak, for example. We now start with a mechanical process of digesting protein, which is to chew very well, and that starts to break the protein up. So if it was some nuts or seeds or it was chicken, you're actually chewing it into smaller molecules so that when it gets into your stomach and you secrete the digestive enzymes that start the actual chemical process of digesting protein, what takes place is that those what actually happens is that the small portions that you've chewed, and the more you chew it, the more efficient this process is, can now be exposed to the enzymes in your digestive tract. And in your stomach, the enzyme that's required to start the process of protein digestion is known as pepsin. We produce hydrochloric acid, and that activates this whole process, and the pepsin starts this process of breaking these amino acids apart. But it's not complete at that point. It carries on and continues into the small intestine, where more of the protein digesting enzymes are secreted as well. And the same thing happens there. You now have individual amino acids that have been broken apart. Differences when we eat things like fruit, which are full of carbohydrates, is that the carbohydrates are already broken down. Very little enzyme digestive activity takes place. It's just mechanical. So when you're chewing an apple, for example, the carbohydrates are already broken apart. They're in a simple form. You don't require this laborious chemical process. The same thing with raw nuts and seeds. When you're eating almonds, although they're 25% protein, it doesn't require this intense chemical reaction, because your chewing is the main part of that. There's a certain amount of chemical digestion taking place, but much less compared to cooked animal protein. What happens when you eat protein, your stomach recognizes that there's concentrated protein there. That means 15% or more, and it secretes hydrochloric acid in direct proportion to the amount, the quantity, and the quality of protein. And that starts that process, as I said. That brings the pH in the stomach to below 3. pH is the measure of acidity and alkalinity. And 3 is a very acid state of the stomach at that point in time. When you're eating carbohydrates, you are chewing the carbohydrates, you're secreting the enzyme ptyalin, it's getting into the digestive tract, and the process that started in your mouth with the enzyme, the salivary amylase ptyalin, only continues in your stomach if the pH of your stomach remains at a level of 4 and above. So now you can understand this dilemma. Carbohydrates require a pH of 4 and above. Proteins for optimum digestion. Proteins require a pH of below 3 for optimum digestion. Anybody with basic junior school science will know that you can't have two separate pH values in one stomach at the same time. It's just not possible. You can't, for example, if I took this glass and filled it with water, and then I squeezed some lemon into it, I wouldn't have the pH of water and lemon in it at the same time. It would mix, and so the pH of the water, which is usually about 7, would drop, and it would be lower than normal water, but the pH of the lemon would no longer be at a pH of maybe 1 or 3, depending on how acidic it is, and now you'd maybe end up with a pH of 4 or 5. So that's what happens is you end up with a condition in the digestive tract where neither proteins nor starches digest very well. And so you've got carbohydrates that are partially digested. They're in a warm, moist environment, and they actually begin to ferment. And the first side effect of fermentation is gas. And if you have too much gas being produced, you're going to have to get rid of that gas one way. You're either going to belch or you're going to release the air. What's a polite way of saying this? You're going to...
Yeah, you stepped in a bucket there. I don't know. It's got to come out. It's coming out through your belly button. Yep.
That's it. Not coming out of your belly button. What people would say in England is they'd say that you are passing wind or passing gas. It's a polite way of saying it. But the reality of it becomes uncomfortable. Now, for some people, the digestive tract may be that they have very small wasted, for example. They're very small. If their waste is lower down, they've got less space for the intestines. They're squashed into a smaller space, and so you find the gas doesn't go around the corners that well, and you could end up with extreme digestive pain. It actually feels like somebody stuck a knife in there and is twisting it. And then they go for a walk, and sometimes it releases it. So the gas is one thing. Then there's ammonia, which is very highly carcinogenic. That's a byproduct of fermentation. There is acetic acid, which is very strong vinegar, and there is alcohol, and it's pretty much neat alcohol. And some people do get the sensation that they have been consuming alcohol when they eat proteins and starches mixed together. They feel a bit lightheaded and not quite as focused as they normally would be. And one of the first things people notice when they eat proteins and starches at separate meals is that their head is a lot clearer.